Dear friends, my greetings of the day and welcome all of you to Asian Polymer Association Sustainability Platform. APA was founded in 2007 with a vision of to bring together Asian science and technology to the forefront of global arena and establish a very dynamic association with scientific world, including Europe and America. The Asian Polymer Association is successful under the leadership of founding president, Professor Bhuvanesh Gupta from IIT New Delhi, to establish a dynamic platform at an international level. Recently, Asian Polymer Association Sustainability Platform is established with a vision to bring together scientists and technologists working on sustainable science and technology of materials for providing solutions to different challenges faced by society currently. I'm very happy to say that today we have very renowned speaker, Professor Shantanu Bhoumik from Department of Aerospace Engineering, Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham, Coimbatore. Dr. Bhoumik, PhD from IIT Roorkee, has established himself as a renowned, outstanding material technologist by working with different academic and industrial organizations at national and international level. His contribution to material science and technology is recognized through many prestigious awards at national and international level. With this short brief, I would now hand over to Professor Shantanu Bhoumik to share with all of us his recent product technology development work based on eco-friendly and green process using polymer waste. Over to Professor Shantanu Bhoumik.
Good afternoon to all. And we say Namaste first. That means we say greetings from our Chancellor Mata Amrita Nandamayi. She is known as Amma as a global leader. And I'll be first giving a brief presentation around 20 minutes maximum. And then I'll show the products. And then after that, whatever questions you have, you may certainly ask to the questions to me. This one.
Stop sharing.
Okay, this is. So I find almost 79 parties attendees. So it's too high. Now 80 is increasing. Just for hold for a moment, I'm sharing my slide. Is it visible to all the slide? I believe so.
Yeah, please go ahead, sir.
Yeah. The first slide, recycling of plastic waste to plastic composite products, waste to wealth. I think it's coming on the, I made the full screen, just a moment. Yeah. Recycling of plastic waste to plastic composite product. I must give my heartiest thanks to my three students, Akash Jayakumar, Akash Vinit and Avias Balaji. They did their BTEC project with me in 2019 and immediately they have their own startup company and to give the solution across the country. The next slide, awake, arise and stop not till the goal is reached. This is the mantra from Upanishad. taken by Swami Vivekananda in his life, it's a very motivating factor. So whatever work we start, we must see the end. We should not live in between. And that work here is the Clean India Mission. This is the fact. On 26th of September 2013, then the Chief Minister of Gujarat, Sri Narendra Damodar Modi, he came to our Chancellor Mata Ramatanandamayi, who is known as Amma, Chancellor of the University, took the blessing from her. And then what he has said, then what Amma has said to him, if he becomes Prime Minister, kindly take the Clean India Mission is the first priority. So it was the mission of Mata Amritanandamayi that was given to the then Chief Minister, who became Prime Minister in the next year, and he has taken that mission forward. Now let me explain this very important slide. Amrita Vishwa Vidyapeetham was established in 2003. According to Times Higher Education's 2020 ranking, it is top 10 in the country along with all the IITs. And we have a very clear focus. In next to 5 or 6 years, it will become top 5 in the country along with the IITs. These are my 3 students, Akash Jayakumar, Akash Vinit, and Avias Balaji. They have their own startup company called Reduce Recycle Recycling and Reuse called RQ Plastics Private Limited in India. Now, we really have a very wrong conception. And among the media or some people, they say we should ban the plastic. We really cannot ban the plastics. You see here, the country like Rwanda, Tanzania, Kenya, Bangladesh, Tunisia, while GDP is very low, they have banned the plastics. But countries like Singapore, Norway, USA, Sweden, Germany, Australia, China, they never banned the plastic. Because while GDP is high, you cannot ban the plastics. Then commodity plastics. We everyone use the buckets, mugs, okay, then the spoons, then the plates, bags, and toothbrush. Suppose if I ban the plastic tomorrow morning, how can you make a toothbrush? Can you go to the washroom without a toothbrush in the morning? It's impossible. Can you have a hair combing without having the plastic? It's impossible. So we really cannot ban the plastics. So the solution I'm coming here, again for the medical plastic, you can see we are using plenty of medical plastics like that, syringe, then the capsule packets, so many. And of course, for the high-end applications where I work also, cryogenic tank, bulletproof waste, blastproof material, fireproofing, all are the plastics material. So it is my own invention, the bulletproofing waste giving to the army, lighter weight composites. Also, I'm skipping this one. Now, this slide is very important. My own survey in Switzerland, this place is called in the Andermatt near to the Alps. You can see the mountain there, absolutely clean and green. Below the mountain, absolutely clean and green. Cows are moving there, absolutely nice environment. It was my experience in 2018, enter November. Next month, I came back and for one seminar, we went to Pauri Garhwal in Devabhumi, which is in the Uttaranchal. On the way to Badrinath, there's a place called Srinagar. Right side is Pauri Garhwal. It's a beautiful mountain you can see, even better than Switzerland. But below the mountain, this is the reality. Dump of plastics, cows are eating those plastics, and we are drinking the cow's milk and affected by cancer. And we say, Gai hamare mata hai. So we are feeding our mata, our utva mother, these plastics. What kind of, no, that kind of a problem we have. Then this is my own survey in Delhi to Ghaziabad. If you see this river, river Jamuna, and India is generating per day 26,000 tons of plastic waste per day. Just imagine. Then if you multiply 665, I need a computer to calculate that one. So every day we are generating 26,000 tons of plastic waste. From Kolkata to Howrah in the Ganga side, same condition. Then my own survey in Kerala in 2018 flood in August. The moment the flood water came down, dump of plastics on the bridge in Ernakulam. So now the condition is that, first, who has made the mess in this country? The plastic waste everywhere. It is we 135 crores of population. We only throw the plastic out, nobody else. Fine. Who will clean? Then we say Modi will clean this. Is it possible that only one person can clean this entire plastic dump? It's never possible. He has given some symbol. The Prime Minister of India has given some symbol that from that we can make the technology and come forward. So this is again one survey in Bay of Bengal. Again, the entire dump of the plastics in Himachal Pradesh, the same condition, same thing in Uttaranchal, same thing in Sikkim. But I would recommend you, any of you, if you come to our campus in Amritsar Vishwavidyapeetham, you will not find a single plastic bag or waste or bottle in there, because we have a recycling plant. It is as beautiful like Switzerland, as clean like Switzerland. You see, it's beside my laboratory, it's absolutely green. The cows are moving everywhere. There's no problem at all. Now, my own survey, I think we never throw any of the utensils, like say, aluminium or say steel plates. Once its life is over, we know how to process it again and make the next product. Similarly, from the plastic waste, whatever the waste generates, we make the product like these roof tiles and these ridge tiles and the footpath tiles. You can see these footpath tiles. It is tested under 10-wheeler truck with a load of around compressive strength of around 15 tons. Nothing happened. The weight of this pavement tiles is only 300 grams. To make this one in injection molding hardly takes around 2 minutes. High productivity. And this we have already been installed in many of the places, say in Ghaziabad, also it is in Hyderabad, is also coming to the in Kolkata. We're giving to Pune also. So installing this one. Then this roof sheet, the roof tiles, you can see here, the roof tiles we assemble. And the important part is that the thermal conductivity of the roof tile is relatively much lower than the asbestos or tin. So therefore, the room will remain much cooler compared to any other roof sheets. So I'm skipping this one once again. This is we have installed in one village in West Bengal, in that high school called Dasagram High School. So entire of this roof is made by recycled plastic tiles. So the plastic bags or the whatever the polyethylene bottles, whatever you have, we collected, we have recycled that one effectively and made this fantastic roof tiles. Then also we have made this with a collection of another industry. We have made this very useful roof sheets. You can see you can easily replace tin sheets or asbestos sheets. Next part is that we have, as you have seen, the Himalayan part particularly, we have 10 Himalayan states, particularly in the summer time. There will be around 5 to 8 crores of tourists, they go there in the Himalayan side. So we generally eat potato chips or kurkure or biscuit, we throw it out. So as a, I would say, civilized person, is it okay that we throw it out? All these multi-layer plastic bags. So which is the inside is the aluminium foil and outside is the polymer coating. From this, we have made the fantastic, furniture. We have made this stool, we have made this table. So there are two benefits. One is that the multi-layer plastics which we are throwing out, the plastic packaging package, we have collected that one and made the very useful, fantastic tables. That means we are not only cleaning the country, but also we are saving the trees. Presently, we are using the wooden trees that can be replaced by this table. Next part, another very important part is the thermocol. So for the packaging, nobody will be liking to have a broken computer or laptop or maybe mobile. So everyone require very well packaged so that there will be no damage in my computer or my refrigerator. So we all making the packaging with the thermocol. But this thermocol, this gentleman is making huge amount of waste. And if you survey a city like Mumbai or maybe Bangalore or Kochi or Kolkata or Chennai, the flood happens because of the gentleman. Wherever you see the drains are choked, rivers are polluting, and lakes are also getting completely polluted because of the thermocol. So from the thermocol, again we recycled and we inserted glass fiber nicely on the recycled thermocol, and we have made a very strong, durable, rectangular product which can be the car bumper, even the support of the car. Then Tetra Pak. Tetra Pak, similarly, everyone we consume, say, fruity or maja mango or lassi or milk. Simply we drink and we throw it out. So from the Tetra Pak, again, we have converted it to this one cotton, and from the cotton we have made the sofa cushion. I'll be showing that one. Now from this technology, as you see, the process: collection of the plastic waste, cleaning, segregation, processing, product from recycled plastics, longer lifespan, and marketing. So in the seven stage, everywhere there'll be employment generation. And our calculation says from this technology, India really can get around 200 MSMEs, and which will be employment opportunity will be around 5 to 10 lakhs. So the process is that you already you have this dumping. We have to collect it. After collection, segregation and cleaning, we have to clean by the plastic bag, then plastics. This is our own recycling plant in Amrita. Then you can see after that we make the shredding. We make small pieces. Then in the pulverizing, we make the powder. Then after we make the finished extruder, we make the granules. When the granules is done, this we are putting again in the injection molding and making this very useful, fantastic products: roof tiles, ridge tiles, footpath tiles. Then we found that we really have in India around 7,600 kilometer coastal line, starting from Gujarat, then Maharashtra, then Karnataka, then Goa, then Orissa, Tamil Nadu, everywhere. So abundance of coconut trees, we can make coconut fiber. Abundance of banana trees, we make the banana fiber. We can mix these fibers with this recycled plastics to strengthen the products. Then I'm coming to the thermoshredding composite for the airliners. Okay, that they make even for this wind turbine or thermoshredding composites. Then these solar panels, we recycle that one, and from that solar panels and this one, we have made the bricks. So from the thermoplastic composite, waste, we have made the roof tiles, ridge tiles, and from thermosetting waste, we have made these bricks, so that in future we really can make waste to the good housing, from the entire housing. This is our entire aim, so that we really can say clean India become currency India. So clean India, once we make, it will become a currency India for the country. My another three students, Tamiz, then Mangal and Visak, they have made their own industry in Chennai on this technology. And then they are making this product of that from this waste. They are making this furniture from the thermoshredding. They are making the bricks and supplying to the villages. Next, my important slide is that my own survey in Sundarban in West Bengal. So since India has around 7,600 kilometer coastal line, what I have seen there, we are still using the wooden boats. And just to make one wooden boat, we are chopping two trees. Okay. One wooden boat having a life of 4 to 5 years, we are simply throwing this after that. That means we are wasting so many trees. So our next plan is that from the recycling plastic waste, can we make the boat? That will be our next project. So we'll be moving. I'm showing some survey here. You can see this one. All the wooden boats we have to replace in near future. So that we really can we can minimize deforestation. And why thermoplastic? No solvent emits, damage tolerance, indefinite shelf life, superior toughness, fusion weld, recyclable, reprocessable, high impact strength. So this is me in Lake Ontario in Canada with a canoe with my friend in David. You can see this kind of boat is very much possible in India also. I have seen Sweden this kind of boats. So process is the same, but in that case, instead of going to the granule, we have to make the film out of it. Then film and fiber with thermoforming system, we really can make these boats like this. We'll have a life more than 30 to 40 years even. So our outcome technology is that the waste will be cleaned. It will minimize deforestation, will generate economy and employment. My another very important area is that everyone are using laptop, mobile phone, then smartphone. I would say even computer, television, making a huge chunk of electronic waste. So what do we do in after 5-10 years, once the waste is generated? Simply we're throwing it out. We have to make a solution in this forum that we really can make the solution. Then when you have dismantled laptop, I found 21 materials. These are my first year students. They're taking technology forward. This is said, we're making this product in 2 years or 3 years time, we're making our own company. Then also biomedical waste is another important technology you have to explore. This is my favorite place, Kanyakumari. You can see this one. the conduct was Vivekananda Rock Memorial, and the Rock Memorial was established by none other than Eknath Ranade in late 1960s. He tried to convince many people that we have to make a memorial in Kanyakumari on Vivekananda. No one agreed. Then he traveled across the country, collected rupees one from each of the houses. Everyone was convinced with his mission. They have given 1 rupee per house, that become 30 crores. And then he made the memorial. So this is my mission. I have given this name, Eknathji model. So this is my 73rd lecture in the last 24 months. I had been to across the country, giving the lectures to the people, motivated them, come forward, because this is a country we must clean ourselves. Nobody can clean. So our mission is that clean India, green India, and make in India mission. Let us collectively strive to keep country's head high, like morning sun in mighty Himalaya. And final slide is that Jai Hind. And because of the liberator of the country, we got the freedom. It's our, how we can preserve the freedom is our own, own way, how we can clean the country. Also, you have to take it forward. I have taken exact 20 minutes. Now I'll be showing all the products. And after you have any questions, you are most welcome to ask me. Yeah. So this is the plastic bags. I think you can see the plastic bags. This is the plastic bottles. Okay, so we are using the plastic bags maximum 5 minutes to 1 hour, and we're throwing it out. The plastic bottles, we're drinking water, throwing it out. From these plastic bags and plastic bottles, we have made this very useful, fantastic footpath tiles. Its life would be minimum 50 years. Tested under 10 wheeler trucks, nothing happened. That means we are just throwing in 10 minutes time, now having a life of 50 years. Once this life is over, thermoplastic, again we can recycle and go for the next product. We also have made very useful, you can see that roof tiles, then the roof sets from this product, and also ridge tiles. Next I am coming to this one, Tetra Pak, like happy, then Lassi, everyone will drink in 2 minutes time. We're throwing it out. Fine, so our job is over. From this, that have been converted to cotton, and then from cotton to this very useful pillow. Just you see, it's very soft, and also anyone can use that one. So from the Tetra Pak, which are throwing it out after drinking, we made a what so useful pillows. Then I am coming to this one. You can see the thermocol which are using, and for the packaging, and we're throwing it out. From the thermocol, we have reinforced glass fiber. It is so strong now, you cannot break it. That can be useful for as a helmet or the car bumper. And also when you have mixed thermocol with ACPS, it's so flexible. We can make the medical shoes also. Then coming to this one, the multi-layered plastics. The multi-layered plastics, you can see that inside is the aluminum foil, outside is the plastic. Okay, very difficult to process because the aluminum melting temperature is around 600, and for the plastic is 200. So much of difference. So what we made in the pulverizing form, mixed with the another recycled plastics, and we have made this so useful, that rectangular block. Here you put the 4 stands, it will become a stool, or it can become a chair or table. That means the multi-layered plastic, which are really polluted entire Himalaya in the summer time specifically, we have made the furniture. So it will be again from waste to real wealth, because it will be really decreasing the deforestation. I think I am almost done. So whatever the plastic waste, we have very successfully we converted to the very useful product. Then just hang on for a minute. I'm showing one more very important product, just for a minute. You can see the bricks. This bricks, no? This is from the thermosetting glass fiber composite for the aircraft. We have taken a scrap from the aircraft. NL having an agreement, they have said they're sending these scraps to us. And from this, we have made this so useful bricks. Fine. So from the thermosetting composites waste, we are making the bricks. and for the
I think we have lost the connection. Let's wait for a minute.
Acha, but everyone got the message, no?
Yeah.
Am I audible to all now and visible to all?
Yes, Professor Santanu.
Yeah, they have seen the products, no?
Yes, up to the brick.
Oh, up to the brick. Yeah, actually, the from the thermosetting composite, we have made the bricks like this. Once again, I'm showing. This is from the wind turbine or from the aircraft structures. We have made the bricks out of it. Okay, so. Now, anyone having any questions, most welcome to ask the questions. And if anyone likes to implement technology in any part of the India, we'll be giving the full support to you.
Yeah, so thanks Professor Bhoumik for a very exciting talk. We have one question which indicates that is a not a question, a query, that I hope the plastics are segregated before making bricks. Is it correct?
Yeah, what is the question actually?
Before making the bricks, is it plastics are segregated?
Correct. Actually, we are making the bricks from the thermosetting. Okay. And we are making this roof type from thermoplastic waste. We segregate first and then we make this.
Okay. Yeah. So this is the one question which I have.
Huh? Yeah.
And I have one query, Professor Bhoumik. As you mentioned that, you know, these products, economic aspects is similar to what you get it from the virgin plastic material. Can you throw some light on those aspects?
Very
how
true.
Much
very
is
because you are a polymer from Reliance person, so I understand the valid question. See, if you have the recycled HDP or recycled PP, it will be the costing scale will be 0.75% of your virgin one. I think virgin one, I think now with the 18% GST is 110 rupees.
Okay.
Am I correct or not?
Yeah. You can take
it. It will be 7 to 75, number one.
Yeah.
The costing is lower. It will be 25% cheaper than the virgin one. And the second and most important point is that what we have also calculated, there will be less carbon emission.
Okay.
Which is the most important these days. Like once we know, once we recycle that one and come to the next product and compare to your virgin from the crude oil to the main polymer to the product, if it is scale up that one, this is coming 35 to 40 carbon emission.
Okay. Very good. So I think I have another one question which has come up Professor Bhoumik, to you, how much percentage of plastic waste is in practice of recycling in India?
Oh, it is really very interesting question. See, now each day India is generating around 26,000 tons of plastic waste. Okay, and out of that, I think hardly 5,000 we are using for the road construction, and there's almost 80 to 90% are lying on the simply in the street. And even if you made a medium scale industry, the plant can take up maximum 50 to 100 tons per day, not more than that. So there is a huge scope for the new industry set up with this technology, and we have to do this.
Okay, and I think there are many questions are coming up, but I can take one more questions. What are the other ingredients apart from waste in floor tiles? What are the other things you are using? You know.
Let me explain this one. This is called your pavement tiles. Okay, this is completely recycled HDPE or recycled PET. We are not putting any other materials here. But the design we have made such a way, okay, with the CAD model, the design we have made such a way that it can really take a load of around 15 tons of compressive load. So we are not putting anything there. And also, what you have seen there, suppose if you take 100 grams of these plastic bags, 100 grams, and product will be coming around 99.8 grams. So only 0.2 grams of some loss.
Okay.
Which is very important, which is called the green technology. And also, as a polymer person, I think everyone knows, we are using in the melting temperature, no decomposition. So there is no emission of any gases in the carbon monoxide also. It's absolutely green technology.
Okay. So there are other questions which I think we will share with you, and you can answer to the participants who are there.
Okay.
And let me one again, Professor Bhoumik, thank you for your exciting talk. And polymers are always the solution provider, as you have demonstrated by developing the technology for certain application. But as such, also the polymers are the solution provider to the society, the many challenges which are faced in different sectors, ranging from health sector, which currently is the most important sector, to food, and also the water, transportation, infrastructure, housing, defense, and space. So there is no doubt the plastics are not the creator of problem, but the solution provider. Only how do we manage it? That is what is important. And you have very in a simple manner explain those different aspects which you have practiced in last several years in science to convert into technology. And we are very hopeful that more new products from the waste will emerge out in coming year, which you can share in this sustainability forum. So once again, thank you for your exciting talk. And to all the thanks also to all the participants who have taken time out and attended this invited talk by Professor Bhoumik. In coming weeks, we will be again inviting you for more exciting talk on sustainability challenges given by the renowned scientist, technologies, influencer, to share their views on how to develop a more sustainable future for all. So once again, thank you, Professor Bhoumik, and all the participants, as well as all attendees who have come and listened this exciting talk. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you very much, Jai Hind.